Thank you both for coming. I know it was short notice.
He said it was extremely urgent.
It is. I have some important family news I want to discuss. Oh, hello, ladies. I'm glad you're here. We're just about to get started.
Yeah, exactly. When are we starting?
Yeah, make it snappy. I gotta go shopping.
Well, Clayton, are we entertaining this evening?
We're always entertaining, Mother. We're the most entertaining family in Corinth.
Would you care to explain that, please?
Certainly. I think we're all here. Gwyneth has already heard, and I don't think Curtis is going to show up.
Curtis is in town?
Yes, he is, but he's keeping a distance. He'll find out soon enough.
Find out what?
What you've been waiting to hear, Trisha.
Clayton, think carefully.
I have thought very carefully, Mother. Trisha, you and your brother have spent your lives running from me, from the Aldens. I brought you here to tell you that there's no longer any need to run.
You see the cars in the driveway? That means that there's a major family powwow going on.
Great. Who wants things easy? Hard is much more
exciting. Oh. Okay, all right. Just okay. Stay close to me, all right?
Don't you know I will?
And get past the foyer, up the stairs, we're in, like Flynn.
Got it.
Now I'm all aware.
Steffi!
I'm staying close.
We'll...
All right. Okay, Nelson.
Okay.
If you run into any of the servants or anything, you just say...
Cooper!
Hot.
Why don't you join us?
Hi, everybody. I'm gonna get rid of my jacket, and then I'll be right back.
Fine.
Okay, now listen, the bedroom is upstairs at the end of the hall. All you have to do is just go there and stay. I'll be right up, okay?
I might start without you, so you better hurry.
Oh, please. Be cool, okay? This is going to take a little maneuvering.
It'll be worth it.
Look at the larger perspective, you'll understand this is in your best interest. Matter of fact, I think this is in the best interest of the entire Alden.
Here you are, dear.
Thank you, ma'am.
Didn't expect you.
Well, Clayton, I'd hate to disappoint you, but you're not getting away with this.
Get away with it? You think I was trying to steal something, when in fact, I'm giving it away.
You cannot single-handedly make the decision to dismantle the company, Clay. The board will never allow it.
The board will have to.
You don't have that power, Clay.
But I do, Stacey. Mother, would you care to tell everyone the news, or should I? Well, of course I should. You see, Mother has very generously signed over all her stock to me. I now hold the controlling interest in Alden Enterprises.
Nana, is this true?
Yes.
I don't believe this. Is that why you wanted my stocks? So you could take apart the company?
I am hoping that all of you can help me change Clay's mind.
There's no need. My mind is made up. I am going to do with the company what I want to do, everybody.
Oh, and what you want to do is tear it apart?
What I want is to gracefully and expeditiously sell off every single last solitary holding. Yes, shocking, isn't it? Good. Oh, Cooper, what do you think of all this?
Oh, yes. Absolutely. Bingo, I agree with you, Clay.
What, Cooper?
You know, I have to go, actually, because...
Cooper, this is your future we're discussing. You own 1% of Alden Enterprises.
Yeah, I know. But, I've been feeling under the weather, and I took this new medicine that knocks you straight out. And I'm just gonna...
Well, then I would suggest that you go right upstairs and get yourself into bed.
Oh, you're so right. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Bye.
Clayton, would you care to tell this family exactly why you're doing this?
I'd be glad to. I am doing this to free my children from the Alden curse.
By throwing away the company?
No, I'm not an altruist, Trisha. We are all going to realize a very generous cash profit from these transactions.
Oh, so this is for money?
No. It's not for money. It is for you and Curtis, and for Christopher, and for Heather.
Oh.
No, you don't seem to understand that I have spent my entire life trying to be the son that Cabot wanted. But now, finally, I am stepping away from his shadow, and I want you and Curtis to do the same.
Now, Clay, that's enough. This is between you and me. You don't need to drag the children into it.
Yes, I do. Because this is all about the children, Mother. I am not going to have the children carry on the Alden tradition any longer. We have had enough lies, enough greed, enough manipulation just to win the next contract or to become a CEO. I am not going to let this man ruin your family like he ruined mine, Trisha. I want something better for my grandchildren.
What a crock, Clay.
Excuse me?
So now you're going to blame a dead man for all the horrible things that you've done to these people and this whole family? What did Cabot do, reach up from the grave and twist your arm?
As a matter of fact, Cabot set this all up long before he was in the grave.
Oh, okay. So Clay Alden doesn't take the rap for anything, is that
Stop
right?
This, both of you. Trucker, come on. Look, I love you for doing this, but you're right. I have to stand up to my father, and I have to do it in my own way, by myself. Will you meet me at the house later?
Yeah, I will. I will. Daughter's changed, too. You'll find out soon enough.
I guess you expect me to be grateful.
I am trying to put other people first.
Oh, really? What about the 15,000 AE employees that'll be out of work? Thought much about them?
You and Curtis have to come first.
Oh, don't even stand there pretending that this is for us. All you do, all you have ever done, you've done for yourself. This is no exception. Trucker?
Yeah, hey, Donnelly.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm good. What are you doing here?
It's just the best slate pool table around. I can come by here sometimes after work and blow off steam. What about you?
Jukebox.
Yeah, it's great. What about that?
Oh, yeah, it's a fashion thing, you know.
Oh. I've never seen you here before.
Well, I just started coming recently.
Yeah? It's kind of a hard place to find. It's a little off the beaten path.
Well, actually, I met a guy.
Oh?
Yeah.
What's his name?
I don't know his name.
Yeah. What?
Well,
Donnelly?
Well, we're not using real names. Right. But he's really nice. He's really great. And, you know, he takes my mind off other things.
Well, don't you think you should find something out about him? I mean, you know, what if you find out that he's got some crazy past?
Trucker, what if he finds out I do?
There's no way to win with you, is there? I try to do something kind, and you find a way to see it as cruel.
Doesn't take much effort.
Oh, Trisha, you have always despised the company. I am giving you a chance to be free of it.
I don't despise the company. I despise what you've let the company do to you. Not grandfather, not Nana, you.
Fine. Then let me put a stop to everything now.
Clayton, I see what you're doing, but if Trisha doesn't know the whole
Mother,
story...
Please don't make excuses for him. I'm not interested.
You see, Gwyneth, it doesn't matter what I say right now. I suppose I'm going to have to save her in spite of herself. That's what you would do, right, Mother?
I would stop all this nonsense and start thinking about running the company I now control.
And let Trisha suffer the consequences, which you know damn well she will.
Oh, you stop trying to justify this for my sake. Even if I did believe you, this is, at best, a pathetic attempt to win back your children by putting half the town out of work. Not to mention throwing our subsidiary companies into a panic. Why? For money? Look around you, Daddy. Do you think this family needs any more money?
No, it's not what we need. And you're not going to get away with it, Clay.
I'm still the major stockholder. I won't let it happen.
As a matter of fact, Stacey, as of today, you are the second major stockholder. And it's close, everybody. Even if you combined all your holdings, I would still be in control.
Well, that doesn't automatically give you carte blanche to just dissolve the corporation.
It won't happen. I won't sell.
Then I'm afraid you'll be holding worthless paper.
Delivery! Anybody in this family still read the news, or do we just create it?
Curtis, we got bad news.
Uh-oh.
Needed a good reason to stay in town? Well, I have one.
Now, listen, I want you two to understand why I'm doing this. It's not for the money. You're still young. I don't want you getting trapped like I did.
The trap is buying into your latest grandstand play.
Trisha.
Save yourself. You always do. We've gotten used to fending for ourselves.
Learning to live without a father was the hardest thing I ever had to do, but now I prefer it. Come on, Curtis.
Trisha, listen to me.
Okay. Why don't we give poor Curtis a chance to settle in upstairs? Now, we can discuss this tomorrow.
Grandmother, it's okay. I don't need to settle in. I'm not staying here.
Well, not here in the mansion, but you're not going until we get this settled.
I think
you're
that
right.
The four of us should sit down and discuss this like a
no,
family.
No, Gwen, there's nothing that you can say that's going to stop me from saving these two. It's for their own good, and I'm going to do it whether they like it or not.
We'll see about that, Clayton. We'll see.
Oh, boy, the Alden War rages on, just like I left it.
Sometimes I wish we had run away when we were kids.
I tried, and I'm right back here again, Trish. And huddled with you on the stairs.
We're adults now. We don't have to just listen. We can do something.
You don't actually want to get involved in this, Trisha. Tell me you're not serious about this.
Curtis, we don't have a choice. We have to care about the company.
I care about my girl, the one I told you about.
Did you find her?
Yeah. And I've asked her to leave town with
me. No, Curtis, you can't. Daddy did say one thing that was true. We can't keep running away from who we are.
I can. Because who I am is going to lose this girl for me.
She doesn't know.
That I'm Curtis Alden? Of Alden University, Alden Enterprises, Alden everything? No. And there's no way I'm telling her.
If we take over the company, we can change it. We can make it something that we're proud of.
Dream on, Trish. If I learned anything these past 2 years, is that running away from being an Alden probably saved my life.
Listen, he's the only guy around that never saw the newspapers when I made all the front pages, you know?
Oh, yeah, Donnelly. Look, everybody's got scars, all right? If he's worth anything, he's going to listen to you. He'll understand.
You know, I don't understand. I can make up such a great life in my imagination. Why can't I do it in real life, huh?
What's this? Let me see this.
This is him. Maybe you've seen him around.
This is a guy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do you know?
No. Just...
Well, listen. Walk me to my car and tell me how you have been. I haven't seen you in, like, forever. Come on. Thanks, baby. It's Christopher.
Trucker. Please help me convince Curtis to stay in town.
Nah, forget it. You guys are lucky I made it to breakfast.
Look, I cannot do this without you. Do you want Daddy to destroy the company?
I don't as much care what he does, as long as he does it without me.
So that's it, then? You're just going to take off?
Look, there's one other complication, this woman I met. I mean, we know nothing about each other, but I don't feel like I'm ready to leave town without her.
Listen, do you plan on coming clean to her, Curtis?
No, I can't do that.
Listen to me, if you care anything about her, you got to be honest with her. Why can't you just tell her who you are?
I just can't tell her.
Listen, what kind of a future can you have if you start off lying?
Look, who knows if we're even going to have a future? I can't honestly say that I'm in love with her, and I don't know that she's in love with me.
Well, it sounds like something serious is going on.
Well, it could be. Look, up at the cabin, I was about as low as I've ever been.
Why?
It's a long story. Look, the important thing is I couldn't see any future for myself, and then she stumbled in there. She's really turned things around for me.
How, Curtis?
I don't know, she's made me feel like everything isn't so out of control. Like maybe there is a life out there for me. She's a really good woman, Betty, or whatever her real name is.
She changes his life and he doesn't even know her real name.
Listen, Curtis, you guys have just got to be honest with each other, okay?
No, I'm not going to blow it this time. Now look, Ronnie is doing okay for now. But every time I become Curtis Alden, something always goes wrong. Just want to get out from under that name.
From under it or change what it stands.
No, look, don't start on me. I'm gonna steer clear, Dad. Every time someone gets close to him, they get hurt. That's why I can't tell her the truth.
You know, you can't keep running away every time things get tough.
I'm not running away. I'm just keeping my mouth shut.
Okay, can I at least worry about you? Look, I'm scared for you. If you don't stand up to Daddy, you're gonna lose a lot more than this mysterious Betty person. Gonna lose yourself.
I'll leave a trail of breadcrumbs. Okay?
Funny. Daddy's not going anywhere. Pretty soon you're gonna run out of places to hide. Don't let him do that to you.
Curtis is gone. He still says he's going to leave Corinth.
Oh, yeah, it's his decision.
I wish he would stay.
I wish he'd stick around, too, you know? But I think your brother knows what he's doing. It's like the way he was talking about this Betty kind of reminded me of me.
Yeah?
You know, when I was just getting to know you. When I was getting to know you, you kind of gave me the same type of feeling, like I was getting another chance to maybe make my life work again. I think maybe that's what your brother's going through himself.
Is it worth him for him to keep all these secrets and leave his home and his family behind?
I don't know. It would have been worth it for me. It wasn't anything that I wouldn't have done to be with you.
Baby, it's not the same. Curtis isn't making these decisions for this Betty. Daddy's still controlling him. Sooner or later, he's going to have to stand up to him.
Well, listen, honey, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, just because you did it, it doesn't mean that necessarily your brother's ready to do it now.
Now is the perfect time. What are you saying? You were the one that told me to stand up to my father.
Come on, let's not talk about this anymore. Come on, get in here.
You finished drawing?
No, I'm just picking up a passenger. Mm. I'm gonna go find white sand beaches. And listen to the warm breezes rustling through the palm trees.
That's nice.
No more board meetings, no stock options. Just sun, sand, surf, and sex.
Mm. Hope I don't need a visa.
I'm with immigration, honey. You know, I'll get you across the border. Just by leaving him alone and letting him work this out himself, okay? Because who knows, maybe one day him and Betty can be as happy as we are.
Curtis is never gonna be happy until he takes control of his life. He's gotta stand up to my father. Finding AE is a perfect opportunity for both of us.
Listen, I've seen what happens to people that go up against the company.
If we don't, he's going to destroy it.
So it's his company. Let him.
No, no, Trucker, there's more than that. This town depends on AE to survive. And so do a lot of other smaller companies. It's just too much at stake. If Curtis and I team up, no one could stop us.
Listen, as long as you know what you're getting into, honey.
What, are you afraid we won't be able to pull it off?
No. I'm afraid you can.
Let me help you. Here we go.
Honey?
Yeah?
I changed my mind. Let's not get up today.
What are you doing?
Come on.
I gotta get up. Oh, okay. I'm gonna get you.
No, you're not. I'm gonna get you.
We should have our strategy meeting about Clay and Aldens Enterprises in this new hot tub. What do you think? Oh, sorry, we're blushing, aren't we? Curtis told me you guys were up here. Should I just leave
now?
No,
it's okay. We're
ready. No, the hot tub's a great idea, Stacey.
Well, you've done a great job remodeling the tide, Strucker.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I'm not finished yet. I mean, there's still all that rubble in the guest room.
It's come along. Upstairs and get Curtis. We can start.
Oh, yeah. All right. Yeah. Be right back.
So how's Curtis doing?
Well, he's taking a room nearby. Uh-huh. So I guess that suggests he's going to be in town for a little bit. He's been on the phone all morning making arrangements with his mysterious new girlfriend.
Well, I think that suggests that he's going to be around for a while. Speaking of mysterious people, have you heard anything else about Shayna's mystery donor?
Only that he means nothing to her.
I think that lady doth protest too loud, don't you?
I think she really digs him, huh?
Yeah.
What if they got together? Wouldn't that be great? She randomly picks this guy to be the father of her child, and then they fall in love, and they get married, and they live happily ever after. Wouldn't that be great?
Maybe she needs a little help from her two creative friends. You mean something more than red, lacy, racy lingerie?
Something like a little push?
Oh, great minds, Trisha. Great minds.
Merci beaucoup.
Mission accomplished.
How long are we going to take?
This afternoon.
Trisha, are we interfering?
Absolutely.
Good.
Well, women giggling, it definitely means trouble.
Hi. Curtis.
You got a suspicious gleam in your eye there.
We're just trying to stage a successful affair de coeur.
And if you were smart with this phantom lady, you'd tell us all about her,
now,
Curtis.
Why would I do a fool thing like that?
Well, because maybe we could interfere or persuade you to let us help you.
Look, I wish you could. Unfortunately, once this woman finds out who I really am, it's going to take a lot more than you guys to save me.
Oh, she has so little faith, Curtis.
No, quite contraire. Just the opposite. I have all the faith in the world in the Alden name and how destructive it is. Now, guys, please, can we get on with this meeting? I've got a lot more planning to do for my evening. This is...
All right,
look. He's pushy, huh? Comes back.
Look here, I just made some rough notes on who owns what at AE. So here we are.
Daddy's got 47%.
Here's your father, see?
Well, Clay needs 51% for total control.
Right, so we need 6% more to add to your 45%. If we could get Mother, Cooper, and Anne to hand over their shares, then we would overrule Daddy, right?
Well, wait a minute, what about Leo Burnell? Doesn't he wouldn't have the holding, the deciding 3%? Isn't that what he has?
Leo Burnell will never give up his 3% or whatever he has of all the enterprises.
Well, we'll just have to talk to him then. I mean, if he refuses, we could have Shayna sue him.
What? On what grounds?
Anything we want. What?
Well, he's starting to sound like your dad.
Oh, my gosh! It's the Alden family curse. Trisha's going to turn into Clay. I'm going to get a passion for power suits and turn into Gwyneth. And you, Curtis, you're going to become Isabel.
Oh, no, never. I hate tea parties. You guys are the latest. Grandmother's trying to get me to move in the gatehouse now.
Well, you just told her that you've already got a place to stay. Definitely.
Yeah, you're not going to camp out behind enemy lines, are you?
Yeah, you might learn to like them.
Not a chance. I'm a free agent, and I intend on staying that way, thank you.
Oh, tell that to your new lady.
Trisha, honey, you need servants. If you're going to run a major corporation, she needs a maid.
Great, Stacey, let me help you.
Well, what is it? It looks like a picture of a couple people.
Oh, well, it is.
It is a couple, actually. It's a couple customers. They were from the bike shop. This guy came and he bought a bike, and he just wanted me to take a picture of it, you know, with his girlfriend and him and the bike and all. And that's all. So we took two. He gave me one. Simple as that. I helped him choose the bike.
Great. Guys, please.
Big deal.
Come on, the meeting. Let's go.
Are we really going to go through with this?
Well, honey, listen, how many other choices do we have? Well, let's just let Clay bust up the company. 15,000 people will be out of work.
No, you're right, We can't let 15,000 people lose their jobs.
And I personally want to see Clay pay for what he did to me.
And look, how do we get to this Burnell guy anyway?
I'll deal with Leo.
Honey, what are you going to do? Are you just going to say, Leo, give us your 3% of AE?
I don't know yet. Maybe I'll have to become a dreaded Alden for a minute. We may not have any other choice.
You know, we could give Leo a one-way ticket to the Middle East. I've got some pals over there who still owe me a couple of favors.
Oh, what a solution.
Let Curtis do it. He sounds like a dreaded Alden.
Listen, I got to get back to the university. I'll see you later, Curtis. If you guys talk to Leo or anything happens, let me know. Come here. Do you think she got it yet? Do you think Shayna got her little surprise yet?
I don't know.
Look, I need a shiny, black, oversized car with a driver. All I need are wheels and a roof. You got a problem with that? Come on. Touchy. Very touchy.
You
thank you.
What's wrong? Is it a busy night for limos?
Well, they had one left with a swimming pool. Tell the guy, it's March. He says it's heated. But the fax machine and champagne will cost you extra. Now, I'm going to go a different route here. Hi,
Do you rent pickups? I need one for today. Great. I'll be down later on. Thank you.
Wow. Listen, Curtis, who is she?
Did my sister send you in here to have a manly chat with me?
No. Listen, man, it's just that you kind of remind me a little of myself before I met Trisha.
Trucker, I have got good feeling about this lady. It could be the real thing. Curtis, how real can it be? You don't even know her name. What she has is more than enough for me.
Okay. But for how long?
Look, I'm taking a beautiful woman out for a romantic evening. That's it, okay? I mean, I'll let you know how it turns out.
All right. Well, listen, I know, I see that you got feelings for her.
Well, you know, the night's still young. You never know. All right, okay. All right, so I hear violins, I can't sleep or eat, and she's all I've been thinking about. Are you happy?
Listen, what I'm saying is you don't really know her. I mean, maybe she's got secrets of her own, no, too.
No. I don't care about her past. I don't care.
Just don't go in blind, Curtis.
I will walk slowly, and I will carry my heart carefully. Now, if I wanted to, I could find out who this woman is right now.
You could? Well, I think you should do that. I mean, before you get into this any deeper.
You're getting very pushy in your old age.
And I think you've been out in the desert too long, my friend. Listen to me, please. I mean, I've fallen and hit my head on the concrete too many times. The only thing that you learn is it hurts a hell of a lot. That's all I can say.